Well, I've just completed a new work for a concert, for a music performance, which is a first-time experience for me. It's based on the music of the 20th century composer Edgard Varèse, who wrote a piece and completed it in 1954 called Désert, or Deserts in English. And the work is about 26 minutes long, and one of the distinguishing features of this piece is that it contains, at three points in its performance, a sort of interruption by pure pre-recorded electronic sound. Varèse calls these three points of interruption or intervention, he calls them interpolations. And so that's really the basic structure of the piece. It's a piece for live musicians interrupted at three points by an electronic kind of collage, which he composed. Now, the beautiful thing about working with video for me is that we, as human beings, one of the essential aspects of our nature is the image. The image is an essential part of what a human being is. I know composers would immediately say sound, but I mean, sound can be a form of image too. I don't mean just the picture. I mean the image that exists inside you. And with the visual image, of course, you have an actual image inside your eye at every moment, a little picture, which is really extraordinary, a little model of the world.
I think he can manage somehow.
I could do this for a little less.
I'm very precise.
Remember, Joey, you know, we tilt the water. Unless you guys can rig it. Can you rig that for us?
Real fast.
I mean, when I make work with video, which includes sound and image together, I feel like I'm working with the closest to thinking and our inner lives, psychological space, that I can imagine. Because the essence of a person is time, and unlike painting, which is a fixed image, this video shows us, and cinema shows us, moving image. And once you put the movement into that, you're dealing with kind of behavior and energy that's really, really uniquely connected to human beings, to what we are. So there's a real connection to thinking and feeling with the movement that we've been given with these images, and it's very exciting. Deserts refers to a lot of things. For myself, and actually reading some of the notes that Varèse had written about this work when he was doing it, it was actually very close to some of the things I had been working with for over 20 years. And that is the idea of the desert as a kind of a landscape, a physical place. The desert as this sort of, at the same time, primitive and future location. It's an absolutely desolate, barren, vast location, which could be in the infinite future or in the infinite past at the same time. It's also a place that causes you to completely rethink and re-experience the nature of perception and the nature of being on Earth, being here, being on the Earth, being in your body. And it also is a metaphor, as we all know, for a situation of isolation, alienation, loneliness, and solitude. I feel fortunate that I'm living at a time at the end of the 20th century when the real hard work was done earlier in the century by people like Edgard Varèse and John Cage and all of the avant-garde, really. They really pushed through this work with an effort and an antagonistic environment that we can't even imagine. You know, a piece like Varèse here, Désert, which is very radical and difficult today in the 1990s, for many people, I'm sure many people that haven't heard it when they come to the performance, they're going to be really shocked and they'll find it very difficult. Now, this piece was done in 1954, that's 40 years ago, and you can't even imagine what it must have been like then. So, you know, I really feel like I'm working, and artists of my generation are working on from the efforts of these people to push this culture and this whole system, to break it open, to allow us to get to the point today where you can do so many things and not, and they won't kill you, you know?
Thank you. Thank you.